Vegas, Tennessee. What stood out? Why would you want to come to Rocky Top?
Well, I've worked with Donnie before, obviously at Middle Tennessee. We had a great relationship. He was actually right down the road for me at Southern Miss. So, you know, during his years there and my years at Ole Miss, we bounced questions off of each other, and I have a great relationship with him.
Working with him, what is it about him? What's a characteristic of him that maybe fans don't see, or something you know about him from behind the scenes?
Well, you know, fans can't see what we do in the office. You know, we're up here a lot. He's a relentless guy, especially with recruiting. Really detailed, organized. That's what we're doing right now. We're kind of beating the pavement, trying to figure out how we need to recruit to put this team together to put a product, a really good product, on the floor this year.
How does being at Ole Miss help you, being in the SEC before, help you coming to another SEC school?
Well, you know, first of all, I've been blessed. I've been fortunate enough to work with Kermit Davis, who's the all-time winningest coach at Middle Tennessee. The same with Andy Kennedy. He's all-time winningest coach at Ole Miss. So I've been blessed to work with some really good guys. And being in the SEC, just kind of knowing the league, from scouting, from recruiting, being able to help Donnie know who's coming back at Georgia, per se, at Florida. I think it helps him, and it helps me as well, to be with a guy that I can trust and I know that's going to work and have the same values that I have.
This player turnover and things that are going on, I know something you can kind of expect when you come to a new place. Donnie's dealt with it before, his staff has. Have you had situations where you've kind of gone through this before?
Well, really, no, I have not, because when I took the job at Ole Miss, I took the job at Middle Tennessee as a grad assistant, and I took the job at Ole Miss. They happened to be done with recruiting when I took the job there, so this is my first time going through this type of situation.
How do you kind of characterize the relationship between the coaching staff and the guys coming back this year? There's trust that has to be built. How is that going?
Well, you know, we just got here, and it's, you know, and it's hard. You know, kids, they don't know us. They knew Konzo and his staff, so it's hard for me to say. I think Donnie's going to address those questions about the kids, whether they're asking for releases or what the things that are going on with them. But I just kind of walked into it, and we haven't really talked about it much. I'll let Donnie answer those questions.
Sure. Yeah. Take us through your playing career at NC State, correct? And after that little pro ball as well?
Well, I played 3 years at NC State, played for two different coaches, Les Robinson and Herb Sendek. Had a pretty good career and went overseas, played in Spain, played in China. Played in a little small country, Qatar, and it was fun. I got to play against Yao Ming in China, a really good league. The Spanish league was really good as well. So, like I said, I've been blessed and fortunate coaching and my basketball career as well.
What would be your biggest responsibility as far as working with individual players?
Probably primarily the posts, working and developing the post players. Recruiting would be probably my biggest attribute here.
Donnie has all those stories about sleeping at gas stations, being as a recruiter. Is it a process that you enjoyed even in those early days when it is hard?
Well, you know, recruiting is, you know, is really valuable to having a really good team. So I think, you know, sleeping in gas stations, staying in hotels, flying out here, spur of the moment, is part of it, and we love it. Obviously, we wouldn't be here doing it. So
you said this is your first time doing this. Meeting your expectations, or how does it match up to what your expectations were with the whole process for recruiting?
As far as recruiting?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've been in this situation before. All of us, you know, we've changed jobs. It's not our first time doing it, so it's par for the course. I like our staff. We got a good group, and we're in there late at night. We're going to work really, really hard, like I said, to put kids in place, to have a good team.